Hi, I'm Logan, DevOps engineer from FPT Software. Today I'm gonna share with you guys an interesting topic about serverless. To know more about the topic, we will go into two parts. Firstly, it's about function as a service, and the second part is about serverless consideration and some use case of the serverless. Before we start this topic, let's first talk a bit about the function as a service. One of the things we've seen is evolution infrastructure start with the bare metal, went to virtual machine, and that's the basis for creating cloud computing platform. Then the container technologies exploded and would apply in many fields because of its outstanding feature. And you know, it is wonderful thing. But as the underlying technologies become complex, many programmers only care about how to write their program. I think they just focus on your business and they want to why their function, they just why the function and execute them. That's the reason why the function as service is really interesting to people, because you just need to write the code and submit it, and the infrastructure already there. And you can see the startup time of the function will be faster thanks to the inheriting the power of previous technology such as virtualization and containerization. Resource uses is also more efficient, and the application architecture is also broken down instead of the monolithic architecture. So we will go over the characteristic of the function. The first, it is event-driven. What you want is an event does come in some way to trigger this function to execute. But it's also very short duration. It's not intended for long-running workload. Function is stateless. All you are provided is computing resource. You don't want to need any storage associated with the function runtime. You will rely on the external service to store the state. Or another way of storing state, you is sending the state to trigger another function. Moreover, I want to mention about an important feature that is auto-scaling. Because what you want is an infrastructure that will scale, that will respond to incoming workload and automatically scale the number of the function to cover the work need to be handled. And one more feature, that's the public cloud talk a lot about is lower cost. We can understand that you just need to pay for what you use. When the function run, the cost will be calculated according to the time the function execute. So you can save the cost of cloud service in monthly bill. In the next part, I will talk about the function deployment pipeline. The lifecycle of the function begin with the writing the code, and you need an additional specification file to contain the configuration information to deployment. Then a builder entity will take the code and specification and compile, and then turn it into the artifact, such as the binary or packet or container image. Then the artifact will be deployed on a cluster with the controller entity will be responsible for the adjusting the number of the function instance based on event trigger, event traffic, or load of instance. Let's back to serverless. I mentioned function as a service, but what are different between the function as a service and the serverless? I'd say that is coming from a cloud, public cloud point of view, where the function as a service is how you actually run the function, how you execute them. Serverless, on the other hand, is the way of thinking. I can let your function to some infrastructure. Someone else is maintaining and operating it. I don't have to care about it. And they will make sure how to auto scale it for you. When it's not running, you won't have to pay for it. Serverless does not meaning no server. Not meaning no server, but the people who use them don't need to worry about the many things of server. And serverless has many benefits, such as auto scaling, built-in high availability, reduce the cost, and no need to worry about many things the server. However, the serverless model cannot be applied in the all application. There are some points to consider when designing application according to this architecture. The first is about serverless stateless. The state in a function will not exist after the function complete the task. This is an important consideration, and the suitable solution must be taken. For example, you can store the session state in a persistent database. Language support is also a point that we need to pay attention to. Currently, service support different language for development. Therefore, the serverless platform that you choose good support for the language that you use for develop the software. Another part is cold start. Cold start happens when an inactive function invoked in the first time. It's time to load the runtime with the library and dependency. Cold start can be increase the execution time and affect to the application performance if not handled suitably. One of the way to deal with it is to make sure the function stay alive before executing. Using the relational database in the serverless architecture creates the scalability and performance challenge. This is due to the limit on the maximum the number of the concurrent connection can be opened in the relational database. Instead, low SQL can be the preferred choice. There are some use cases applying serverless on function as service. The most popular ones is microservice. The feature of microservice is splitting application into particular function. You can implement a function according to the API that you need. IoT is another use case. The work behind it can come from the device calling in. You cannot predict the when an event happened. Therefore, you need an infrastructure that can scale processing capability when need. One more use case is the batch and stream processing. The use case need to automatic scaling serverless service. And with the DevOps, with your CI/CD, you can configure the event to trigger from any step in to execute the function. In IT Ops, you can deploy bots according to the function model to perform many administrative tasks. Yeah. This is an image taken from CNCF about the serverless landscape. There are many related products, such as the tool framework, hosted platform, or software that you can download and install on premise. Apple had different advantages and limitations depending on the nature of the job. I hope you can be through the right product to apply for your business. That is the end of sharing. I hope it's helpful for you. Thank you for listening.